His unofficial nickname at the White House is Secretary of Everything, but another nickname for Jared Kushner could just be the landlord of everyone. His family's real estate empire includes 20,000 apartments, 13 million square feet of other real estate across six states. The Kushner Company has a stake in everything, from luxury penthouses in Manhattan to modest apartments in Ohio and New Jersey. Jared Kushner even disclosed a small financial stake in this mobile home park in Union, New Jersey. No kidding.
It's right here on page 32 of his 54-page financial disclosure form, the Park Lane Mobile Home Park. You'd like to walk around the park with him?
Yeah, and show him all the stuff that needs to be taken care of.
His financial disclosure does show the president's son-in-law resigned or divested himself from several of his holdings, including a somewhat controversial building at 666 Fifth Avenue. He's also resigned from his position in the family business this January. But as a whole, Jared Kushner remains invested in nearly 90% of his pre-White House real estate holdings, 124 properties, most now held in trust.
Is he still involved in these projects?
I think he's got too much on his plate at the moment. I mean, you can't try to solve Middle East peace and be the liaison with the Pentagon and also look at properties. But he has a financial stake in these properties. He's not divested from everything.
The Kushners continue to make big deals just without Jared. In May, Kushner's sister was widely criticized for mentioning her brother's role in the White House while pitching Chinese business owners to invest in the company's billion-dollar development in New Jersey. That role in the White House also raised concerns when the Kushners were trying to attract a Chinese bank to redevelop a potential real estate flop. That building at 666 Fifth Avenue that's $1.4 billion in debt. The Chinese deal fell through. The family still needs to refinance, but Jared's no longer involved. He sold his stake when he went to the White House.
So just what does this all have to do with Russia after all? None of Jared Kushner's 54 pages of financial disclosures disclose anything about Russia. CNN has been told by sources that the special counsel is focusing in on an odd meeting Jared Kushner had here in December at Trump Tower with the head of Russia's state bank.
It wasn't just any Russian state banker. It was a Putin friend who attended Russian spy school, a mega-rich banker named Sergei Gorkov. Gorkov heads one of the Russian banks facing stiff sanctions from the United States. And to add a little intrigue, Mr. Gorkov isn't talking.
What did you really speak to Jared Kushner about in New York when you met him in December?
No comments.
The Russian bank and the White House have two very different versions of what that meeting was about. The Russian bank said they talked business. The White House says they talked future U.S.-Russia relations. And both versions have fueled speculation. If the bank's version about a business meeting is true, congressional Democrats want to know whether Kushner might have brought up his family's troubled 666 building and the need for a new loan, which could cross ethical lines between his company and his role as advisor to the president. If Kushner's version about it being a diplomatic meeting is true, it raises questions about whether the bank brought up U.S. sanctions and appealed to Kushner to drop them.